¿Cómo estás, guys? Today I'm proud to present to you 2021 brand spec new Kia Rio. In this video, I'm going to show you the interior as well as the exterior of this car. So, guys, here's the key. Basically, lock, unlock. Good looking car indeed, inside and out. Alright. Smart key access system also is available. Hold to enlarge trunk and remote start. Hold this button. Come on. What the heck is going on? Once again, I'm gonna wait for 15 seconds, maybe more. Alright. Come on. Nothing. Nothing, just like that. Alright. Let's move a little bit further. This time, I hope this thing works. Nothing. What the heck is going wrong? What the heck is going on? Alrighty. Anyway. The start works fine. The mechanical key built in into that slot. Very simple. White exterior. On a base trim, a 15-inch rims is available. And on top trim, 16-inch rims. Smart key access system, of course, to lock the car, basically. And to unlock his button, chrome bar handles. Wide opening doors. Easy access. But interior, perforated seats. This car has, I believe, 6 airbags, 3 spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel. Alrighty, let's hop on in. But my 6'3" stature is quite easy to get in and out. Not bad at all. Alright, guys, brand new car. This particular has only 308 kilometers on the clock. Push button ignition, now to start the engine. Put your foot on the brake and then hit button start. It's quite easy. Very nice startup. Drive carefully, as you can see. Alright. Horn, manual tilt, and telescopic. Very convenient. This car comes equipped with electrically assisted power steering opinion. Very fluid steering wheel. Not bad. This car has automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers. Right now, let's turn headlight. Front rear fog lights. High beam, soul search lights right there. Bar folding exterior mirrors. Like so, very convenient. Especially in tight parking spaces. Left and right, use this joystick to adjust. Also heated, of course. And power window lock, your central lock. Driver side window fully automatic in both directions, up and down. Back windows. Airbag built in. Side curtain airbag. Alrighty, guys. Like so. Not bad. Right now, let's open the hood and take a look at the exterior of this car. Blow right there to open the hood. It's quite easy. This car doesn't have a power moonroof or a panoramic moonroof, even on top trim. Shark thin antenna, high gloss black finish, as you can see, for a stereo system. A lot of chrome. This side, handles, rear defrosting glass, 5 years warranty or 150,000 kilometers factory warranty. Your, of course, third brake light, red frosting glass, LED tail lights, fake exhaust, chrome, rear parking assist, rear fog light, license plate lights, independent McPherson strut style suspension with anti-roll front and torsion bar out back. Your fuel tank is around 50 liters. Combined fuel consumption for this vehicle is 7 liters for 100 kilometers. Not bad. Multi-spoke aluminum rims, 16-inch. Tires measuring 195/55. Front ventilated disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes. Not bad. Alrighty guys, right now I'm going to show you underneath of this vehicle. LED turn signal kits next to rear mirrors. Beautiful. Your VIN number, very good visibility. Different sensors right there. Nice looking rims. LED headlights. Of course, your fog lights. Ejector right there. And bulb right there. High beam and low beam LED. Front parking assist. Key emblem, a lot of chrome, high gloss black finish. Alrighty guys, here's the engine. You do have choice between two different engines, 1.4 liter normal aspirated, inline 4, 16 valve, it produces 100 horsepower, and this one, 1.6 liter, also normal aspirated, inline 4, 16 valve, it produces 123 horsepower, 6-speed manual and 6-speed automatic is available. Alrighty, this is your coolant, radiator, fan right there, oil dipstick, washer fluid reservoir, you change the bulb basically, it's aluminum engine, aluminum block, ABS and ESP, your brake fluid, spark plugs, battery, air filter, fuse box and relay located right there. That's pretty much it. The ground clearance is around 160 millimeters. Not bad in general for the economy car. Alrighty guys. Right now I'm going to show you the front suspension of this vehicle. Pretty much everything is covered, as you can see. A lot of chrome, Tahac, front parking assist, LED daytime running lights of course. Not bad for its price, good warranty. This car is really fun to drive. Sensitive brakes, interesting steering, a lot of space inside and out. Of course, for the economy car. For its price, it's just a South Korean bargain, definitely. Also, a smart key access system for this door. Alrighty guys, right now take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part of this vehicle. Your tweeters right there, main speakers. This car has 6 speakers, storage area, bottle holder, all your power amenities located right there. Hard touch plastic, for the armrest, fuel cap release and trunk release right there, tire pressure monitoring system, 185, 65, 15 inch rims, and 195, 55, 60 inch rims in this case. Lumbar support, two-way power right there, seat high, recline sliding, seats are quite nice. Yeah, pedals. OBD and fuse box. Oh, I get it right there. So, Russian specification, of course. Alright, here we go. Panel dim, tire pressure monitoring system, traction control off, and hot headlights. Two-tone plastic, it's hard touch. Alrighty guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Well, red needles. Not bad. Engine, and here's your light indicator controls, your intermittent wiper controls, voice commands.
Please say a command.
Help.
Select a microphone button to access further information on available features. Please say the item shown or select it directly.
Phone.
To use the phone, please say the item shown on the screen or select it directly.
Exit.
Terminating voice recognition.
Not bad, especially for this class of vehicle. Not bad. You can increase and decrease volume, see control buttons, of course, different modes, your favorites, unhook and off buttons for telephone. Via Bluetooth, you can connect your telephone and receive calls, and also Bluetooth streaming of audio. Not bad. Your cruise control settings, driver information system right there, quite easy to use. OK button. Let's see. Of course, different settings, average and current fuel economy right now, it's not correct. Your lights, basically, different settings, door, also the same, convenience, all right, service interval, then your theme selection, theme A, B, C, good. Other features, all right, not bad. Your language, choose your desirable language right there. It's quite easy. All right. Then reset. That's pretty much it. Your digital speedometer. Engine start and stop button right there. Single zone, fully automatic climate control, your fan speed, air conditioning on and off. Get temperature adjustment, one touch automatic, quite easy to use, quite easy to adjust, front and rear defrost, windshield wiper deicer, recycle, in different modes, facing, etc., and off, quite easy to use. Of course, USB, right now, as you can see, my thumbnail connected to it, say kitty, but there is no auxiliary or actually SD card, 12 power socket for your phone, some space right there. Alrighty, here's your map. Quite easy to use, quite easy to adjust. So you can see different settings for the map, favorites, your radio, basically, media, how it sounds. For the stock audio, sounds pretty good. bad. General settings for the system, profile, voice recognition, display settings, different modes, general settings, system information, time and date, language, as you can see, keyboard layout, sound adjustment. It's pretty much self-explanatory, as you can see. Then your navigation button, phone connection, basically your Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. What else? Wi-Fi hotspot, pretty good. As you can see, right here, QR code for your info. Awesome. High gloss black finish right there, interesting mess. heated steering wheel, 2-stage heated seats for the driver and for the passenger. Turn up the parking sensors, as you can see. Like that. 6-speed automatic transmission, shift lock release, your review camera with guidance lights. You can adjust brightness, daytime mode, nighttime mode. Not bad. But resolution is not so high. Manual shifting, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. But wrapped, high gloss by finish. A lot of interesting stuff right there, such as this trim. So, for a key, a brake, silent, nothing but silent. 2 cup holders, searching button, adjustable armrest, not bad. Manual gym rearview mirror, of course, microphone for the hands free, QR code for your manuals. There is no illumination for the vanity mirror. Illumination reading lights right there, and SIS emergency roadside assistance. Of course, your sunglass container, it's also padded, very soft. Awesome. This side, all handles right there. My 6'3" stature, those seats are quite nice, leg room is more than enough. That support is pretty good, and shoulder rooms are okay. Not bad. Awesome vehicle inside and out. Love it, love it, definitely. Alrighty, guys, right now let's check the back seats, shall we? With my 6'3" stature, once again, it's quite easy to get in and out. Trunk release and fuel cap release. Double stitching, airbag for the driver, for the passenger, airbag right there and right there, and for the pillars, 6 airbags. Nice, very nice. Alrighty, here's your fuel cap. A little fuel only, of course. Cushion. It's all plastic, by the way. Back seats. 64 to split back seats. Absolutely gorgeous rims. As you can see, child safety locks. Heated seats, 2-stage for the passengers, high and low, off. Power windows, of course. Speakers, search compartment. Also preferred, double stitching, SFX system, chest anchors, 3 adjustable headrests, like so. It's quite easy. But unfortunately, there is no central armrest in this case. So, there is no storage pocket right there. Legroom is quite limited, and my headroom is also limited. My gosh, it's pretty tight right there. Extra cut hook located there. And of course, with illumination, your power supply, USB, almost completely flat floor, and one storage compartment for this side. Not bad. Look at this interior. It's just a beauty. It's just a beauty. Awesome. Inside and out. Of course, illumination right there. It's not LED. Interior illumination. Visibility is not so good, in my opinion. Alrighty, guys, right now let's check trunk space, shall we? 480 liters. It's not so big, as you can see. Floor mat, and down there you can find your spare tire, tools, and basically jack, wing triangle, illumination up top. Awesome. Wiring. Rearview camera. sound isolation, in my opinion, is not so good, especially for this key area. Main rivals for this car is a Skoda Rapid, Volkswagen VW Polo, and Hyundai Accent, I believe. Maybe Hyundai Verna. Same story for this side, heated seats, two stage, that's it. Search area right there. Same story, silver plastic. There is no lumbar support, electric, and seat high for passenger seat. Glove box is not lockable, as you can see. It's not so big. Well done, well done. Consider the price, guys. I don't even know. Is this car good enough to buy it? Consider it or just avoid it? I don't know for sure. But in my opinion, it's good looking, with good warranty, fun to drive, reliable, excellent fuel economy. It's just what you expect from this Kia from South Korea. Alrighty, guys, alrighty. Very simple car indeed, extremely simple. So guys, hope you enjoy my first in-depth tour and at the same time I believe test drive on this 2021 brand spanking new Kia Rio. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, thanks for subscribing, truly appreciate it. Have a good one, guys. Mm-hmm.